Hey guys, for today's project, we're casting a bronze trench knife. Trench knives started out as improvised hand-to-hand weapons in World War I, as armies struggled to adapt to the brutal realities of trench warfare. The earliest trench knives were made from modified bayonets or steel stakes used for securing barbed wire, but by the end of the war, they were commonly standard-issue weapons. Although there was a wide variety of combat knives used, the classic style that we're imitating combines a blade with a brass knuckle style handle. Because brass knuckles are controlled in many jurisdictions, our trench knife is only being designed to act as a letter opener. For the prototype model, I started by tracing out a brass knuckles model from Thingiverse and adding a large custom blade to one side. After printing the first half of the knife, a quick fit check immediately showed that the finger holes were too large for my hand. I also didn't love the size of the central cavity, so I decided to remodel that as well, in addition to adding some additional features along the knuckle line. With the greensand packed, we need to widen the inlet spout into which we'll be pouring the molten metal. The plastic copy is then removed from the mold to form a void between the two layers of packed sand. To ensure good flow, we had vents at all the sharp points in the mold for air to escape through. In keeping with the brass knuckle theme, our trench knife will be cast from bullet casing brass, left over from previous projects. Melting brass requires the foundry to run at a much higher temperature than aluminum, about 500 degrees Fahrenheit hotter. To reach this temperature, we're burning lump charcoal rather than briquettes, and using a cover to reduce wasted heat. The inlet sprue is removed with an angle grinder fitted with a cutting disc. The vents are then removed with a dremel and a pair of pliers. Some flashing along the seam of the mold is removed by a combination of the Dremel's sanding band and a round file. The angle grinder's grinding disc is then used to put a rough edge along the length of the blade. The edge is then refined and sharpened with a file. Finally, the blade is sanded and polished with increasingly fine grits of sandpaper. Oh crap, this was important. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. Or don't, I am not a beggar.